Hey there, folks. Santee at the Arizona Ghost Riders here. Mail. Hey, Santee. How about one on saloons? A few of you. Wait, haven't we done one on saloons? Bartenders, bars, whiskey, mixed drinks. No. Let's do it. In just about every Western movie, the first building a traveler enters when arriving in town is the saloon. It's the place the drifter can cut the dust after traveling endless days over the vast Western landscape. But it was much more than a drinking establishment.
Hey, Clint, want a drink?
Well, let's look into it. The word saloon comes from the French word salon. Salons were gathering places where people met to talk about current events, party a little, and solve the world's problems. Saloons in the Wild West were very similar. They were first and foremost places for men to drink and gamble in. In some instances, they were makeshift courthouses, theaters, eateries, and barbershops, and sometimes brothels. Proper ladies would not dare be seen in saloons, being that they were dens of wickedness. There is even documentation that mentions the proprietors offering space on the dirty floor to sleep on for a small charge. If the hotel was full up, then it may be a better choice than setting up camp outside of town, which could be uphill, in the snow, barefoot.
We lived for 3 months in a rolled-up newspaper in a septic tank.
Luxury.
Like today, towns and cities typically had more than one saloon. They weren't all grandiose like the Western movies portray. Many took up small lots in town, just enough room for a bar and a few tables. In the mining towns, it was common to see tent saloons with dirt floors. Once these establishments became more prosperous, they would build a permanent structure.
I ain't drinking with no donkeys.
Prescott's Whiskey Row has some terrific historic watering holes. Maybe the most popular of these is the Palace Saloon, which was founded in 1877. Arizona Red and I drove up for a movie premiere and decided to swing in and wet our whistles.
What's the matter?
Which one of you's talking to?
As mentioned in a previous episode, the Palace burned down in 1901, but the patrons got the bar out before it was engulfed in flames. Another interesting thing about the Palace is this little raised cubby overlooking the gambling tables. I was told that in the day, a man would sit in there with a shotgun to discourage cheaters. Now, I plan to visit more historic saloons in the future and introduce you to their grandeur and history. The sequel to the Amazon Prime Western Seabar was premiering, and Arizona Red is doing some background in it, so we headed up to see it.
Welcome to the premiere of the second episode of the Seabar Saga.
Yeah!
Terrific weekend in a great Arizona town.
Another shot, please. Well, folks, that's it for another episode. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you on down the trail. Hey, Red. What are you doing here?
Having a drink.
Oh, okay.
What does it look like?
I wasn't sure.